Your thoughts determine your actions, and your actions determine your results. It is only if you give up that failure is permanent. I always say marriage is an ancient institution. You can't live it with modern rules. The power of a mother. With this message, I want to do a few, I just want to do some simple things. The first thing that I hope to do is that I hope that women will get an idea of what God had in mind when he designed mothers. That we'll have a clearer understanding of that role. And for the men, I'm hoping that you will see the powerful package God has given you in your wife as a mother, and perhaps also a deeper appreciation of your mothers. And I know when I'm talking about mothers that I'm not only talking about those who have given birth as such, because there are many women who occupy mothering roles, even though they may not have biological children. Many of us can think of teachers who've played a mothering role in our lives. We can think of mentors. We can think even sometimes of bosses who have taken a mothering role in our lives. And all these people need to be celebrated. So when I'm saying mother, I'm talking about sisters, I'm talking about mentors, I'm talking about teachers, I'm talking about all of those, even dads sometimes, who have functioned in a motherly role in our lives. Now, as I was preparing this message and laying a foundation for it, I began to think, why did God put us in family? I know that may sound a little bit silly, but the truth is that God could have created us to exist as autonomous units. You know, there are animals that just give birth to their children and move on. You know, turtles do that, fish, you know, they give birth and then the child from day one is left to fend, you know, on its own. Alternatively, God could have made us like Adam and Eve, who were born as adults. I mean, God is God. He can do anything. But he designed, he packaged it so that a man and woman would come together, give birth, and that they will be raised in a family. And so it gets me to thinking, why did God do that? Why did he give certain qualities or characteristics to the man, the father, and certain characteristics to the woman, the mom? And as I thought about it, it became clearer, because God has a purpose for everything that he designs. There is nothing that God designed or made that is a mistake. So if you exist, there is a purpose for your life. And if God created the role of mother, then there is a purpose for that role. And God fashioned mothers to have certain characteristics because of the function or the purpose that he wanted them to fulfill. So power as a mother comes from discovering and walking in that purpose that God has created mothers to fulfill or to accomplish. So today, what we want to do is we want to discover the purpose God has for mothers so that we can be powerful or effective mothers. So I'm going to be sharing characteristics of a powerful mother with you. Okay? So the first characteristic of or the first power of a mother is the power of nurture, the power to nurture. You know, literally when a baby is born, it's dependent on its mother for life or for survival. Before the advent of feeding bottles or expressing, you know as mother moms now, we have, from the moment we give birth, we have machines stuck to our breasts, expressing milk and stuff so that we can leave them and go to work. But before technology got so advanced, a child literally had to be attached to its mother's breast to survive. That was what the child depended on for survival. So when that child was here talking about the 9 months he lived rent-free, that was only the beginning. They've been sucking the life out of us since the day they came out. So a baby is literally dependent on its mother for survival. Its nourishment, its sustenance is in its mother. So number one is the power of nurture. Now number two is the power to multitask and to organize. Proverbs 31, 14 to 15. Although I know many women hate this scripture, they say, I know women, there's a camp of women who are against the Proverbs 31 woman. because they believe she sets an unrealistic bar. This is what the scripture says. It says she's like the merchant ships. She brings her food from afar. That means she goes to Dalston Market to buy fish. She goes to Billingsgate to buy something else. She goes to Upton Market to buy spinach. She goes to Costco to buy bundles and bundles of toilet roll. You know, when I come back from Costco, my husband is like, how many years will we use to use this toilet roll? She also rises while it is yet night. She's often the first one up in the morning, making sure that the whole house is running. She provides food for her household and a portion for her maidservants. But she doesn't leave it at home. The scripture says she considers a field and she buys it. So she has her own enterprises. She has her own things going on. The power of a mother is the power to multitask and organize. Why is that? God designed women a certain way. I found this out when I started doing research on communication. I found out, how many of you know that you have two parts, a left and a right side to your brain? How many of you know that? I hope we all know that. Now, the interesting thing is that a woman's brain is different from a man's brain. And the reason why is that there are more connective tissues between a woman's left brain and a woman's right brain. That means it's easier for a woman to make linkages. I'm not trying to diss the men. Go with me. But the way a man's brain is organized is that if a man, the reason why men often have a problem expressing feelings and emotions, one side of the brain is kind of rational, is concrete, the other side of the brain is more creative, and is feelings controlled. So a man, because there are less tissues, literally has to close down one side of his brain and move to another side of his brain to process information. But because there are more connectors for a woman, what she's feeling, she can be telling you as she's feeling it. So if you really want to make a man sad, ask him, what are you feeling? He needs time to process it. We as women don't understand that, we get frustrated.